couple of videos, we have learned how to use linear algebra to identify steady state and stability of steady state for a linear homogeneous system of ODEs. However, most of the models in biology will be non-linear. In this video, we will learn how to use the methods of linear systems to analyze a non-linear one. For this, we have to use multivariate calculus. Let J be a function of x and y. We can represent this as a curved surface in three dimensions. We have a point on that surface at x0, y0 and z0. Now I draw a line on this surface passing through this point. I have drawn it in such a way that along this line x and z change but y remains same at y0. I have marked this line as cx. Tx is the tangent to this curve at that point x0, y0, z0. As y is constant along this curve, I can easily calculate the slope of this tangent using derivative. Keeping y fixed at y0, we calculate the derivative of f with respect to x at x0. So, we get the partial derivative of f with respect to x at that particular point. By the definition of derivative, I can write del f del x is equal to limit x tends to x naught f of x y naught minus f of x naught y naught divided by x minus x naught. By rearranging the terms and by approximation, we get f of x y naught is equal to f of x naught y naught plus x minus x naught into del f del x. This is similar to what we have seen when we were studying Euler's method. In fact, this equation is the equation of the tangent Tx. Similarly, we draw a curve Coy such that x remains constant along this line. We use the same method of partial derivative to calculate the equation for the tangent of Coy at x0, y0, z0. This time, we use the partial derivative of f with respect to y. Notice that these two tangents and the point x0, y0, z0 are all on a plane. Using the equations for these two tangents, we can easily get the equation for this plane. That is, f of xy is equal to f of x0, y0 plus x minus x0 into del f del x plus y minus y naught into del f del y. This equation is at the heart of what we'll learn in this video. Now let's get back to the system of ODEs. Suppose we have a nonlinear system of ODEs of two dependent variables. Dx dt is equal to g of xy and dy dt equal to h of x and y. G and h are two functions. As it is a nonlinear system, it can have more than one steady state. Suppose x0, y0 is one of those possible steady states. Using the equation that we just learned, we can write g of xy is equal to g at x0, y0 plus x minus x0 into del g del x plus y minus y0 del g del y. Here, x is very close to x0 and we are taking the partial derivatives at x0, y0. Similarly, we can write another equation for h taking its partial derivatives. As x0, y0 is a steady state, the first terms on the right hand side of both the equations are 0. So we can simply get rid of those. Let's write this set of equation using matrix and vectors. Now we can substitute many of these terms. Using the ODEs, replace the vector of g and h by the derivative vector. Now consider x minus x naught as P and y minus y naught as Q. As P is equal to x minus x naught, dx dt is equal to dp dt. Similarly, dy dt is equal to dq dt. This matrix of partial derivatives is called the Jacobian matrix. Note that here we are calculating the Jacobian at the steady state x0, y0. So replace this matrix by J. With substitutions, eventually we get the compact form. P dot is equal to J into P. This is nothing but a linear homogeneous system of ODEs. Not in terms of x and y, but in terms of p and q. Now we can use all that we have learned in last two videos on this particular system of ODEs. If the determinant of J is not equal to 0, then there will be only one steady state at p and q equal to 0. And we can decide the stability of this steady state by calculating the eigenvalues of J. In fact, we can use a trace determinant plot of J to identify the stability. We will take an example, but before that, try to calculate the Jacobian matrix for this system of ODEs. Let us take our old predator-prey model as an example. So we have two nonlinear ODEs. Dx dt is equal to x minus xy. Dy dt equal to xy minus y. This system has two steady state, 0,0 and 1,1. We will check the stability of these two steady states one by one. First, calculate the Jacobian. The Jacobian is calculated by taking the partial derivatives. Be careful about the arrangement of these partial derivatives in this matrix. First, we will calculate the stability of the steady state at 0,0. So, replace the values of x and y with 0 in the Jacobian. Now, we will check the trace determinant plot of this Jacobian. The trace is 0 and the determinant is minus 1. We are below the trace axis. So, this steady state is a saddle. Now, the other steady state, 1,1. Again, we will analyze the trace determinant plot. For this steady state, trace is 0 but the determinant is positive 1. We are above the Euler line on the trace determinant plot, but on the determinant axis. So this steady state is centered type. One steady state is a saddle and the other one is a center. So the overall phase portrait of this system of ODEs should be a mix of these two types of phase portraits. We have seen the phase portrait of this system earlier. In the positive quadrant, the system will have closed trajectories. That is because the steady state at 1,1 is of centered type. But note, the Euler trajectory is not a proper ellipse. The ellipse has got deformed as the other steady state at 0,0 is a saddle and it affects the trajectories near it. In the rest of the quadrants, you can easily detect the behavior of a saddle. Let me jot down the key points of this video. In this video, we learned to analyze a nonlinear system by linearizing it around its steady state. A nonlinear system can have multiple steady states. We determine the stability of each of these steady states separately. In doing so, we get the phase portrait around each of these steady states. First, identify the steady states. In many cases, you can find the steady state very easily by using null lines. Take one of those steady states and calculate the Jacobian matrix for that particular steady state. check the sign of the eigenvalues of this matrix. You can identify the phase portrait and stability using the rules that we learned earlier for linear systems. For example, if all the eigenvalues of the Jacobian are real and negative, that steady state is asymptotically stable. If your system is two-dimensional, it is better to use the trace determinant plot, then you need not to calculate the eigenvalues. Repeat this step for all the steady state. The system may have different behavior around each of these steady states. The overall phase portrait would be a combination of all those behaviors. That's all for this video. Thank you for learning with me.